our thoughts, right? In terms of how we see the EV market, it's like that. Particularly the third national car, probably a range extended EV car would be up, hopefully by this year, right, by Mr. Willing. And eventually by 2024, we'll have a potential mass market. We've got about 10,000 cars on the road, right? I'm looking at 2030, right? This is the target given by GreenTech with respect to 100,000 cars. That will start the market moving. What are thoughts that come up to my mind? What is this? Is EV green? This has been asked many, many times. I'm going to try to answer that question. Number two is, EV charging is just offsetting of fuel versus power plant supply. Especially coming from Tanaga National, we generate, right? We are having greener power stations like Manjung 5, which has the higher best coal technology. Dato is there for Perak, right? We tell everybody we are greener, right? Nobody is really green. They're just greener. Even if you use EV cells, you are not actually green, isn't it? Based on the production process of EV cells itself. But yeah, we are greener. Then the other question I ask myself is, what's the catalyst required to make those numbers real? And what will propel EV take up rate faster? So this is a question in the back of my mind. We did a bit of customer statistics from the Malaysian context, right? What you see basically here is that younger people, someone not like me, but younger people, they like. Now, these are guys who are not even owners of cars. We just ask them, what do you like? They say, yeah, I don't mind an EV car. They haven't heard the price yet. High income customers tend to show higher interest in EV charging, probably because they can afford it, isn't it? Finally, on values not shown, customers who select EV chargers are generally more, I can't even see myself, engaged across values. Now, let me show you the next slide. This is more interesting to me. What you see on your left hand side is about how customers buy energy. Every economy, in the start of EV charging, they tend to give it for free. Right? The free part has gone. Customers today prefer more chargers pay per use. They don't mind paying for it, but they need more chargers. They have range anxiety. Address the range anxieties, charge them for it, they don't mind paying for it because they are not the free loaders at all. Right? That's what I understood by this slide. And finally, we signed up yesterday, TNBX, with Sam Darby with respect to putting green homes. One of the things that I intend to do with Sam Darby also, putting an EV charger in place. My biggest challenge is, if I put an EV charger, for those Malaysians to know, we have a tier tariff for domestic side. You'll be hitting the highest bracket, 57 cents plus 1.6% plus 2.5, you're paying 60 cents per kilowatt. How do we try to break that up? Have a smart charger that's connected to the cloud and able to give them a different rate with respect to EV charging. That's about the idea we want to toy with Sam Darby and the rest of the developers with respect to EV charging. Now, there are numerous parties interested in EV. The guy in the bald head, that's me without a turban, okay? Finally, rising EV vehicles in the market, whereby more than 10,000 have been registered since 2018, studies from RTD. Many may not know, lack of availability of chargers in public as well as high-rise buildings and apartments. These are the guys who sleep or work for 8 hours. They want chargers where they are, right? Potential lack of green in EV charging, questions that we ask ourselves. Are we really helping while we are trying to do green on this side? Are we helping putting a charge here? Generally, yes. A small combustion engine compared to a big power station, obviously the economies of scale is better there. But are we really green there? Right? Question we ask ourselves. Lack of private investors in EV charging infrastructure. I thought this was true till I put an interest in the market about 2 years ago and asked, which one of you would like to do EV? Look at the answers I got. Fastag, ByWire, Park Easy, SoCar, and so on and so forth. There are a lot of guys interested in doing it, trying to find a business model to how to get EV done. So finally, I summed up the challenge like that. One, based on the general information, and what the customers say. One, an innovative business model to drive more chargers and cars in the market. Two, an ecosystem that every industry player gets to do. Three, making the ecosystem green. I find it very hard to use that word democratization, but it's exactly making it available for everybody. Everyone feels that Tanaga National is the only player in the market. We are not. Right? There are a lot of players playing in the market. Just that you don't see them as fast as we do. But democratization is allowing everybody else to play the game. How are we going to do it? An idea. One, supply must come from the grid. Who generates it doesn't matter, but who connects it generally is Tanaga National. Presently, the grid co, guy who supplies it. Two, we need to put green into it. This park is the wholly owned subsidiary of Tanaga, but it could be many players, right? They call them RPVI. They are photovoltaic investors. There are 40 of them registered in SEDA. Look them up. All these guys, right, including those participating in LSS 1, 2 and 3, right, would be the guys generating the green electrons. What does TNBX do? Well, we put a platform in place. You all heard of platform, I heard it about 6 months ago, and I thought this was the answer to what we need to do. So we put a platform in place, and what does the platform do? One, it connects the utility and green to those interested in providing infrastructure. To sell energy in a regulated VIU type of environment is difficult, licensing and so on. The platform gets rid of the licensing, so you just have to go and sell energy, right? So we're talking to a couple of guys. I'll show a video at the end of this, how we partnered Park Easy. Anyone from Park Easy here? Good. I can say what I want. Finally, there is an EV supporting industry required. Batteries, repairs, etc. and so on. Normal workshops won't do it. OEMs like Volvo, which I drive, insist I go back to them, right? But there is an infrastructure required, right, for the industry to make moving. Then there is something else, a business modeling. What you see here, there are a couple of guys that we have spoken to. Freeling wants to do a taxi service. They believe that if you have a green taxi, a guy will opt for a green taxi again and now the car. SoCar believes that anyone wanting to rent a car will rent a ruin car more than anybody else. So there are a lot of guys playing with models, trying to look for a scheme. What we have done here is put a platform, taking energy out of the solution, right, the challenge, and just saying that I have given you green energy, think of the business purpose. And finally, we've got green. Presently, TNBX is also involved with respect to setting up a platform called MGATS. My boss not here. MGATS is my boss also, but MGATS, Malaysian Green Attribute Tracking System, right? We are launching it next month in IGEM. Ability for you to buy green energy through an REC. Okay, green EV charging. How do we implement it? Easy. One, energy from small panels is fed to the grid through the various large-scale solar systems, LSS 1, 2, 3, as I mentioned before. Two, we use a certificate. I was talking to Electrify. Those of you familiar with Singapore will know who Electrify Martin is. Martin around? No? Right. We're saying that if you can aggregate all the EV charging and show in real time how much are you generating through green, the balance of it, you could actually retire RECs. And EV charging could be really green, all right? Three, we need an apps platform, the one we have done. And finally, what you require is indirectly the energy that is flows in your car is generated from a green source. Easily said, generally best done by a utility. That's what Tanaga National, through TNBX, is partaking in trying to get this done. Prelude to public, this is due first. EV vehicle prepayment system by TNBX, they're trying to do something. Charging through pay-per-use mechanism, RM per kilowatt. EV customers, a platform, an app charging infrastructure. Finally, this is the apps that allows you to buy and sell. It's just buy, right? It's not V2G, it's just buy energy from the grid. Eventually, right, from a V2G perspective, you could use similarly a net off on a cloud platform. On the first quarter of next year, right, we have got a proof of concept in my office. If those of you familiar with Tanaka National in Jalan Timur, we've got 9 bays already for the last 6-8 months. We're testing out the technology, the platform, the charging, and so on. Just to prelude how the apps looks like, something as easy as this, it's about 5 steps. If you're familiar with Starbucks, where you pay, you buy upfront a card, similar to Starbucks. You just upload a card from any wallet, right? Eventually spend as you want. And you're buying actually green. The back end takes care of totality, ensuring that you got racks, you know, retired, etc., and so on. Now, that's what we intend to introduce. Okay, thank you. Now, before I finish off, I want to show you a small video where I act in it. Asian is smiling. Can you have this video? This is showing you that if we democratize what we do, we can partner anybody intending to do E. This is a partnership we show you in a video here with Parkeasy. Right, guys. Collaborate with a lot of people with respect to how do you get EV charging green, app that takes care of parking and also charging. With that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being a great audience.